Hey you and welcome. My name is Mr. Barry. In this whole video, I want to introduce some of the computer classes that I'll be offering here for the fall 2021. Now, if you can't make it during that time for period, don't worry. The classes will actually be recorded and will be right there in my YouTube channel. I'm going to be showing you where to find the playlist of the classes here in just a moment. But if you do live in between the Visalia and the Fresno areas of California, you can actually participate and come to the class and be there in person for these free computer classes. So what is the computer literacy class all about? Well, it's actually more than just a computer literacy class. This course is designed to train the student in using a wide variety of computer systems effectively in the areas of media, word processing, spreadsheets, social networking, email, digital photography, and so much more. We'll be working within the Chrome operating system as well as Windows. We'll be working with cell phones. We'll be working with Microsoft Office and Google Docs. We start with lesson one on day number one, which is a quick introduction to PC basics and logging in. By lesson number two, we'll be going over terms, PC navigation, email, and working with Google Docs and looking at the basics. From lessons 3 to 9, we'll be working with word processing with Microsoft Word and Google Docs. From lessons 10 to lessons 12, we'll be working with spreadsheets with Microsoft Excel and Google Sheets. Lessons 13 and beyond, we'll be working with other applications, such as working with our USB drives, learning how to speed up Windows and other Office suites. We'll be looking at Outlook, Windows Explorer and Paint. We'll be working with digital cameras, GIMP, Photo Stitch, as well as looking into PowerPoint. We'll also be looking into working with our cell phones. And if you're interested in actually registering for the computer class, maybe getting some of the material, some of that type of thing, well, I do have the phone number right here for the Selma Adult School, and they're the ones who are maybe sponsoring the class, you can say. And I'll be using their facilities and having the classes there at their site in Selma. And so there's the phone number that you can use, and they will give you the location and also the times. It will be on Tuesdays between 4 and 6:30, but if there's any change or anything like that, do use that phone number there to get the newest information on these computer classes. They will be starting August the 23rd of that week, and we'll be going on and meeting every Tuesday. We usually normally have 16 lessons or 16 sessions. And if you look at my YouTube channel on the playlist, you'll say, well, there's more than 16 lessons or 16 sessions shown there. And that's because on some of the classes we actually go through two of the videos, sometimes we go over three, because some of those videos are simply mini lessons that are part of a larger lesson for that day. So let's jump into my YouTube channel, and I'm going to show you where the playlists are located for my computer classes. Hey, here I am inside of my YouTube channel. Now, to find the YouTube channel that I have here, just go to YouTube, type in or key in Selma Teacher 7, boom, and then you'll be able to find me by that name there. Now, if you go in, you'll notice here towards the middle it says Home Videos. So if you click on Videos, you get to see the newest videos I've uploaded there. And then after that is Playlist. Now, the playlist are here for you so that you can basically find videos that are all related to each other. So on the very first one we have security. So I do have a number of videos that are nothing but security, how to do things better on the internet and safely there. And the very next one after that is our computer literacy class. And that very first one there, it says 2020, but I'll be using the same lessons there for 2021 here. So if you click on View Full List, comes up, and you can actually see there's actually many, many lessons that we go over. And I said earlier, sometimes we go over two or three of these videos in one session because many of them are mini lessons that basically work with the main lesson. All right, now if I go over to this side above me here and I click on that arrow, you'll see that there's actually many more playlists there. And one of the lessons or one of the classes that I'll be having too for free there is the Network Control Operator class. And it says 2017, but that's because basically it still works, it still fits even in 2021. What do we cover there? Well, we talk about upgrading computer systems, doing things such as repairing computer systems, building them, fixing problems within Windows. Even working with our Chromebooks is found in there as well. So if you like to work with your hands, if you like to repair things, or if you need to repair things, the Network Control Operator is for you. Now I will be adding new lessons or new little mini lessons to this list. So even though it says 2017, every once in a while you'll be seeing new videos incorporated into that playlist. For example, right now I'm looking at a website that is really offering a really good service as far as being able to go in and get your or reset your Windows password as well as other passwords on your computer system. Now I do have videos or lessons on how to do that manually, but with their software, you just basically use their software and it does it for you. So it kind of skips a few of the steps, makes it a little bit easy. And if you're a novice at this, then you know that's the way to go. So I will be adding or incorporating some of these little mini lessons on that here in the near future. If you go in there, you'll notice that I do have older lessons for like computer technology mini lessons. If you're new to computers and all that, then there may be some really good videos information in there for you. If you're using a Chromebook, the computer literacy courses that we will be covering this time, that's perfect. That's actually what we're using in the class is we'll be using Chromebooks. Now some of the students will be bringing in their Windows computers. No worry though, because you can actually do all of the lessons either on a Windows, a Mac, or a Chromebook. It's just that in the computer classroom, that's what is given to us there at the school site is Chromebooks. And since it's a low-cost device, many people are bringing in their own Chromebooks. If you notice there, I do have a playlist called Acer Chromebook CB515. Basically, I go over using my Chromebook. If you've been a subscriber, and if you haven't subscribed yet, I hope you do subscribe. The button is right above me, by the way. If it's red, you click it to make it gray, and you click on the bell to receive notifications when new videos come about. So if I go and click back onto videos, you notice one of the very first videos there says Acer Chromebook CB715, comparing the CB315 and the others, which is best for you. So that's one of my later videos on recommended Chromebooks and basically how they differ. One thing that you should be aware of if you are buying a Chromebook is you want to make sure it does have a touchscreen. You may say, well, I don't really need a touchscreen. The reality is many of the apps, many of the programs that you run or use on your Chromebook, as you use it more and more, you'll discover that they are touchscreen only. And so if you do have a touchscreen with your Chromebook, basically it opens up the world for you and you can do more things with your Chromebook. So you'll notice I have it right here. It's called Acer Chromebook CB715. Another thing to be aware of if you are buying a new Chromebook is which processor it has. So we're looking at the faster ones have the Intel processors, and that would be the 4400 or above, you know, a larger number, maybe even a Core i3. Mine that I actually use comes with a Core i3 processor. Of course, I use that to create and produce these videos. So there are actually many, many videos here. And if you were looking for a specific one or a type of topic outside of the playlist, you can actually jump to this magnifying glass. And if you click on that, then you can simply key in a word or a phrase and find the videos that are related to that word or phrase. So there's hundreds and hundreds of lessons there for you. Everything from connecting a printer to your Chromebook to even installing Chrome OS on a Windows machine. And so there's many, many videos up there. So there you go. Now you know of the new computer classes that are happening this fall. Hey, if you like these types of videos, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already, and comment down below, because I do read all of your comments, especially if you have a question on like how to set up your printer with your Chromebook or how to do something else there with your computer. Just go ahead and type it into the comments, and I'll get to those there as soon as I can. Hey, thank you again, and bye-bye. Thank you.